to look upon your children, Lord, dear Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon every sanctuary, Lord, throughout the nation, Lord, every pastor, Lord Jesus, every disciple, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon, Lord Jesus, the apostles, Lord. Look upon the prophets, Lord Jesus. Look upon, Lord Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus. The missionaries, Lord. Look upon the pastors, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus. We ask you, Lord, take charge, Lord, and have your way, Lord. Let your will be done, Lord. Not mine, not theirs, Lord, but your will be done, Lord. According to your will, your way, your grace and mercy, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, look upon the heads of the countries everywhere, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. Look upon our President Barack Obama, Lord. Look upon his heart, soul, and mind, Lord. Give him to know, Lord, that you're God, and besides it, there's no other, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, take charge, Lord, and have your way, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon your peoples everywhere, Lord. Look upon this neighborhood, Lord. Not just this one, Lord. Neighborhoods throughout this world, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Look upon the fathers and mothers, Lord. Sons and daughters, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your presence right now, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your anointing, your grace and mercy, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord, take charge of the service today, Lord, and have your way, Lord. Let your will be done, Lord. Not mine is not there, Lord, but your will be done, Lord. According to your will, your way, your grace, and your mercy, Lord. These blessings and others, we ask in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. At this time, I'm going to turn your hands on the praise team. Let us receive them by the words of amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. blood out there, isn't it?
Yes.
Is it snowing?
Yeah.
Wow. In the mountains, it is.
The snow's worth more than the rain.
Oh, wow. We are really excited this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord a great big praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I like that song you are singing. We're going to go right back to that. We're going to be off of schedule a little bit. Can you do birthdays, Julie?
I didn't do nothing yet.
Well, I'm going to go off schedule because I just walked in the rain. And you guys are all praising the Lord the way it should be. Shouldn't hold back the show. Amen?
Amen.
It's a show to God. We're showing God our love. Amen? It's not a show like an entertainment show, but it's a showing of our love. It's a showing of our adoration. It's a showing of our devotion to Jesus Christ. And it's a thanksgiving. Amen? Well, I want to just tell you something. I've been bursting all week, been crunching up numbers. You know how we had our Miracle Sunday anniversary?
Yes.
And boy, was I blessed. The church was blessed, and I was blessed. Thank you for that beautiful tribute you did in the Sunday service to me. I told Pastor Fonda, I don't think I've ever felt this much love in my entire life. Amen. And it was really just a blessing. I've got some numbers for now. We know what our goal was. Our goal was just a number. Alright? Because we have a number to pay off.
Amen.
But I want to encourage you that I know in my heart, because I know everybody here, I know that we did, every person here did their very best to get to the Lord. I know the Lord was smiling down and he is very pleased. Amen? He is really pleased at what we've done. Okay, I want to tell you that on the night of the... Okay, first of all, we had collected $1,681 up front that had been collected before the night. Then Pastor Fonda and I had given ours up front, which was $1,300. And then the night of Miracle Sunday, our Miracle Sunday offering that night was $5,381. Hallelujah! That made our total offering $8,362. Hallelujah! That was good! God is so good! Amen? And so we're still, and I had a couple more people call and say, can we still make pledges? We want to get in on this. And I said, absolutely.
Amen.
And so we're going to be doing. We had about $2,000 in expenses with our speaker, you know, because we flew him out, put him in a hotel, gave him $1,000 offering the way you're supposed to, amen?
Amen.
And so we had about $2,000 there, and then we spent probably, I haven't crunched all the figures, but probably between $500 and $600 on training and advertising and that type of thing. Anyway, basically, no more than $3,000. So we still came out over $5,000 to $6,000 ahead when it was all said and done. Amen?
Amen.
Boy, that's a blessing.
Amen.
That is a real blessing. And so, we can make one payment a year. So we can either pay it off or make one payment. And we have up to April to make that payment. So we're going to take I'm committed to taking at least $6,000 and putting it aside out of the general fund.
Amen. Praise God.
Because you leave the general fund, have you ever known how that happens?
Yes.
This comes up and that comes up, you know?
Yes.
So we want to pay at least what we took in on that tax bill. Amen?
Praise God.
And we're going to set that aside in a separate account and have to take it out of our general fund. And we have a couple more places to come in. And then we may wait till the Valentine's banquet, but then we're going to make that payment. We're going to be darn near paid off. We'll have whatever we pay on it, and then I believe that within a month or two, it'll be newly paid off. I truly believe God's going to do what He said He was going to do. And I told you, like I felt in my heart, there are people that want to come alongside of us and support us.
Praise God.
But if we did our best, God would honor
Amen.
That.
And,
I really feel like we did our best.
Yes, amen.
And I'm really proud of the congregation. And, and for our visitors and newcomers, it's not about money. That's not why we come to church. That's not amen. What I'm about. But we want to walk in integrity. We want to walk free and clear of any type of debt. We have a big job to reach this community.
Amen.
And we have another lot that needs to be built. I'll go ahead and make a couple of announcements. I'm going to step on Julie's toes. I was going to bring her up. I'm going to still for the birthdays in a little bit. But I didn't get the announcements to her. It's not fair to try to like throw them on her and say, yeah, they're making the announcements. So there, and you'll see we have a big announcement. See, God is doing something here. He's moving in a miraculous way. Where we used to, at the top of the program last week, it said Miracle Sunday Revival. In fact, I put at the top, miracles abound daily. Amen. Miracles abound daily. And and that context an acronym. He's done. Miracles abound daily. There are just things happening here to where God is showing Himself real. He's showing Himself real. Oh, on top of that, the church blessed me because of the team that Barbara had up to do the dinner, the banquet night. Not only did somebody bless me with a new washer and dryer, and not only did the church end up with a washer and dryer as well that we're going to have here, but on top of that, because the dinner was not catered, the money that was usually gone to the catering was given to me as a love offering. And that was, it was over $600. So, and that was a blessing to me. So not only did we pay our bill down, but I ended up with another love offering for my family. And believe me, it helps. Amen? And I believe we're going to reach the harvest. I received a call from Upper Room. You haven't known David Emily Yost.
Amen.
And they said that we're going to be in northern, we're going to be up north for a conference over the next on the 15th. You can't come in the morning, but you can come in the evening to do a evening service. And so next Sunday, plan to come out in the evening. Now, if you don't drive at night and you need a ride, let me know. We're going to, or Pastor, let somebody in leadership know, because we'll make arrangements so everybody that wants to be here can get here, okay? Because I know some people are bright at night, starting to rain, but Upper Room, they minister in song, they minister in the flow of the Holy Spirit, you know, with the word of knowledge and the anointing and the word of encouragement. And it's not costing the church a bunch of money, but it is coming. Amen. So they wanted to come yesterday morning. I was inviting men to the men's breakfast. And I was sending out invitations. And you men that didn't make it out, try to make it out next week. Maybe next month. It is really a blessing. I have a blessed time. But I was sending out invitations, and I thought I was sending one to Billy Hensley. Who was Billy Hensley? And instead, I sent out to Billy Simpson, someone in my phone book, you know, my phone. He called me up and said, how do I know you? I said, I don't. He said, where are you? I said, Sacramento. He said, I've never been to California, but I'm an evangelist. And I go through that. He said, I've never been to California. I'm an evangelist. And we got compared notes. We couldn't figure out how we knew each other, where we met, why he was in my phone contacts, you know, why he was on my Facebook. And I said, well, you've never been to California? What do you do? He said, my family sings Southern Gospel music, and I have preached the Word of God. I'm a Southern Gospel, Southern Baptist, Pentecostal minister. And I said, well, praise God, it's about time you come to California then. And so he said, believe it or not, I've got my schedule in front of me in the motorhome. My wife's got it in her lot. We're going to give you some dates in October. This is what I'm talking about. God is sending, He's stirring.
You know, yes, He is.
And he's opening doors for people to come in. So if you want more of the Lord,
hallelujah,
we're going to reach out and get it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Next Saturday is the ladies' breakfast.
Yes.
It's usually on the third Saturday. This is what I think you'd be doing. It's usually on the third Saturday. But it's going to be on the second Saturday this month, because on the third Saturday we have a TLC soup kitchen dinner at the Robertson Center. But we're going to be out first to pray for people in the community and to help however we can help. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And the Denny's that we usually go to is not available on the second Saturday. So for this one time only, say one time only.
One time only.
Until further notice. They'll be at the Denny's in Thomas by the new Sizzler. You know, you remember that sign? The address, you have your pens?
Yeah.
Okay. It's 4441 East Commerce Way. 4441 East Commerce Way. And I didn't get it from the walk-in.
Off the road.
Okay, thank you. The password, but our volunteer coordinator, Marcy.
I have an address and I call the ladies.
She'll call and remind you. She always is faithful to call the ladies. If Marcy doesn't have your number, ladies, and you want to be included, make sure that you get that to her at the church. And I almost called Brother Cleo, but I didn't know what time you got up with Brother Cleo. I was up at 6 in text messages, and I thought, I don't know if I'll wake him up this morning today. But praise God, if you're not, we need fellowship.
Amen.
We need fellowship. And if the breakfasts are reasonably priced. In fact, yesterday you could have yours free because they're doing a promotion. So if you want to go deeper, and you want to get to know your brothers and sisters in Christ more, we will give you these opportunities to come out and fellowship. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So, we have a good time. And so, those are the two main announcements. I wanted to tell you about Miracle Sunday. I'm just bursting inside of joy. I know that we are. Isn't the word God says to speak those things which are not as if we are?
Amen.
And I just have the faith to know that we have accomplished our goal. I know we have. Because we've done all we can do to stand, and then the word says to stand, therefore. And God is going to finish this job, amen.
Amen.
And so I want you to give the Lord and give yourselves a great big round of applause. Amen.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, let's sing that song that we're singing, Hallelujah. Let's go back to worship. And I noticed we have some new people in church today. Right back there on that row next to Scott, next to Bill. Who is that next to you guys?
My daughters.
Your daughter. Hey, welcome.
Amen.
So, let's go back there and worship the Lord some more. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. Everybody likes my parade. How many people got their boots on? I was looking around, I thought, had to drag our boots out today. I was so happy. I got to put on my sweater. I got to see Marvin Snuggly. Isn't that fun? Get rid of those old hot clothes. Put on some Snuggly clothes. I was so happy. I went to a concert, a Christian concert on Friday night. And have you ever heard of Shonda Pierce?
Yes.
No, Shonda Pierce.
She's funny.
Funny?
Yeah. Oh,
she is so funny. I'm telling you, I wet my pants. I'm not kidding you. All you women know about that, right? I'm telling you, she was funny. She was funny. I laugh so hard. When I laugh, I choke. Because I have asthma, and I can't help it. So I choke. So I'm sure they thought I was dying, but I was laughing. It was so funny. How many had a birthday this month? No birthdays, I don't believe that. November birthday. You have a guilty look on your face. You have a November birthday. If you have a November birthday, I need you to stand up. Right now.
Come on, Sam.
Adopt the family all these years, but we had noticed that they could no longer
help out with families. So I said, okay, plan B. And I thank the Lord for that. There's several things. We have our Thanksgiving dinner the 21st, which I forgot to bring the flyers or put on the wall. The 21st is a Saturday at the Robinson Community Centers. I need volunteers.
Amen.
We're going to have a prayer room. And also, there's going to be other flyers of things given out. I would like our church to hand out flyers about our services. And if they want to know where Victory Tabernacle is, anybody from Victory Tabernacle, tell them all information.
Amen.
Okay, that's number one.
Noon, right?
It's from 12 to 3. But that's when we serve. Now, we'll be there before 12.
Amen.
Because they have the Vision Caravan. Bobby and her crew used to come and set up and decorate for me, so they're on a different schedule. We have servers. We have, I've asked the Pastor Taub and the praise and worship team come. And then also they have a youth group come help serve also. We'll be getting back with everybody. Right, Lil? We'll be back. We'll be back in touch with them this week. What TLC and Victory Tabernacle are doing this year, we're sponsoring 30 families. We also have a school at Bell Avenue School that we're going to be sponsoring all the kids for their holiday treat before they go out for Christmas vacation. We also have we have 31 turkeys we're looking for to give out. Victory already have pledged 10. This time we expected to happen years ago. We didn't know when it was going to happen, but it's going to be lean years. And this one's the leanest years we've ever seen. But we're on plan B. Everybody's going to get something for the children and families, so. And then we're prepared for next year. I feel like Joseph, when he's in charge of all the grants,
yes,
and the enemies had to come and get ready. We had so many phone calls, so we only could do what we have, and that's all we're going to do is say thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
So we're going to need help. Sister Marcy has a sheet. I'm numbering the families on the sheets now, so they'll come and pick up the gifts for their families in December. We'll get the date to you later. And we have them bags where they come to service and pick up their bags for their family. Thanksgiving, we're going to give them a turkey and a gift certificate to take care of the Thanksgiving dinner. And plus they can come to eat Thanksgiving dinner with us on the 21st. There's going to be a vision care van there. They're going to be able to check the eyes and everything and refer you if you need a specialist or if you have glaucoma. And we have other specialties given out that day. It's really hard. It's a lot more families than we've ever seen before that need help this year. Pastor sent a letter out. In the letter has an area where they go to Salvation Army to get toys for their children. But they have to sign up now. So we've been very busy. And it's not going to let up until after the first of the year. And I thank the Lord for each one of you all helping, participation. After church, Sister Marcy's going to have some cards. On these cards are children's names. You can take one card, you can take two, you can take five, you can take all of them. But they're for to buy a toy for a child that has a child's name and age. That particular card has to be stapled to a bag that you bring your toys back in. And they're to be given out the second week in December. I need a date on that. So we want every family to be sponsored. And you can take a card today or next week. But be sure to sign your name, what child you're taking, so we know who to come back to. Praise God. Any questions? I know I talk fast.
When did you say it has to be returned?
I'll let you know next week because I have to look at the date. I don't know the date on the calendar. At least by the 15th of December. Probably, I would say the 13th of December. That way I know I'm ahead of myself. Because we're going to have a dinner. A Christmas party like we used to have.
Uh-huh.
And you bring your item back wrapped with the child's name taped onto the item, and we'll put them by families in a bag. Some families have five children, some have two, some have one, and they'll be put in a bag, and then we'll know the family. The families are numbered from 1 to 30. So we put the name on the tag also if they're one or number 30 or number 29, and that'll go into a bag with all other siblings' toys. And they'll come pick it up, and I want them to come to church to pick it up.
I want them to see a church service.
So they come to church service. After that, we'll bring the bags out and hand them to them. That's the only way they're going to get them.
Yes. And tell the age group.
The age group are from 12 to 1.
1 to 12.
Well, actually, 12 to 5 months, I think, again, from 5 months.
3 months.
3 months? 1 to 3 months. 1 to 3 months. Okay. 1 to 3 months. And, I mean, 12 to 3 months. Those are from electronic toys, and then it happens. So, so we'll get them hats or gloves or something like that. But, any questions?
Yes. Can you take a whole family?
Sure, you take a whole family.
Because I can get a family and get my family to help the family.
No problem. If you want a whole family, I'll make sure you get a whole family.
You can take as many as you want.
One grand. I think we had about 70 children all together. 70 children that have to be adopted out. And
under the age of
15. Under the age of
12.
Under the age of
12.
Yeah, with the 15-year-olds, and we had some a 17, 18-year-old. But I find that doing this all these years, they're not as appreciative, and you ask them what they want first, oh, I want an iPod, or I want a laptop, or another school. But anyway, the children are little kids, and they have games and toys, and girls have dolls. So use your discretion, and we'll have the list after church for you to sign up with, and I think that's kind of what I'm saying about. And we have food that's going to be donated to them. If you want to contribute to the food and not toys, you just let me know what you want to do. If you want to do anything, that's fine too, but we need to know so we know where we have to go to get whatever to fill that hole in. So I'm very appreciative of that.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, you can.
If you take 2 or 3 children, say if you want to buy them an outfit and the toys, is that all right?
You can do that. They've done that in the past too. They ask what size they wear, and they buy them a toy and a sweatshirt or an outfit. Let me tell you, it's a lot of hungry people out there. Right down the street from Bobby is like an overpass, and they may have an overpass right here off of Rio Linda. People are sleeping on that every day.
Yes.
Every
yes.
night.
Yes.
And then also we have...
sleeping in
cars and stuff. And they have their babies with them. I get cold in the morning. I can't imagine me sleeping in a car with my family or anything. We never had to do that. It's very bad this year. But there's other resources that they can get to them if they want to. They get to cash those checks. I tell them to cash your check, and I get to get things for your kids. And also we give bread on Monday, Tuesday, Friday, Saturday. Come and get the bread. Because I'm going to stop going. I'm not getting out of every morning I get up, Bobby get up, Edward get up, and we have 2 other volunteers. We go get the bread, and no one's taking the bread.
Oh, I take the bread.
So take the bread. There's a whole room of bread out there. And Mama, Papa, towels back. Get the bread for your group. Mama, Papa, towels back. Get the bread. We get fresh bread. God has never given us any junk. That's why I'm not expecting anything less than be this year.
Amen.
So he always blesses with the wonderful things, like say, from volunteers to the prayer room, to buying toys, clothes, or whatever you want to do. There's a job for you to do. And I want to make sure your name is on my list. Praise God.
Sister Mary, I need one of my tech guys to take my phone because the Wi-Fi shows up for the church. Because I have a new phone. Hold on, Matthew 25, Brother Kevin. That's what I was going to do. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Matthew 25. See, everything we do according to Scripture. Amen? It's not a social club, it's the body of Christ, amen? And there is a reason we do everything we do. We are intentional in what we do. We base everything on the Scripture. And go through the parable that Jesus told about the sheep, the great king, and go down past the loaves and the fishes. First of all, it's not wonderful how God talks about in Matthew chapter 25, he tells us how he multiplied the loaves and fishes and fed the 5,000 men, plus the women and children. He's a God that provides more than enough. That's why I said I knew he was going to take care of this church, and we gave our very best.
Yes.
Go ahead and go up to verse 31, the great king. Okay, verse 31. When the Son of Man shall come in his glory and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all the nations, and he shall separate one from another, as the shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. You're going to be a sheep, and you're going to be a goat. No. That's how we say, nay, we don't know, nay, we don't want to be a goat, we want to be a sheep. Then the king, the same thing on his right hand, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and ye gave me meat, I was thirsty and ye gave me drink, I was a stranger and ye took me in, naked and ye clothed me, I was sick and ye visited me, I was in prison and you came unto me. Then shall the righteous enter in, saying, Lord, when saw we thee at hunger and fed thee, or thirsty and gave thee drink? Or when saw we thee a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothing? Or when saw we thee sick, or in prison and came unto thee? And the king shall answer and say to them, Verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it to one of the least of these, my brethren, you have done it unto me. Amen. Then shall he say unto them on the left hand. Now it's nice to be rewarded, but look what he says to those that did not take care of the needy. Then he shall say unto them on the left hand, Depart from the ye cursed, and the everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. And then he goes through and he says that we saw them hungry, we didn't feed them. We saw them sick, we didn't go see them. We saw them in prison, we didn't take care of them. So we saw them naked, we didn't clothe them. I'm glad to say we're a church that is doing what Matthew 25 said the sheets of God can do. Amen?
Amen?
So when people ask you what kind of a church you go to, instead of saying, oh, we just went to a little small church over there, why don't you tell them, we go to a church that's reaching the needs of the community. We're lifting Jesus up higher, and we're doing the work of the kingdom of God. You see, the laborers are few, but the work is plentiful, and the harvest is plentiful, and we need to work while it's still daylight. Amen?
Amen.
The word says, be not weary and well-doing. Amen? So that means not to get tired of doing good things for the kingdom of God. And so, this season, we're excited that God's given us another opportunity. When we got the email back, they canceled it last minute. The Adoption Family Program was doing for 10 years. Bayside and some of the bigger churches were having the families adopted. They didn't take care of their needs because they are a welfare congregation. So they would take care of their needs for us. And I would make sure there were no con artists from Sister Mary's help and team. And we would talk to the other pastors, and we would get the list together, and we would turn it in on November 1st. This year, we turned it in November 2nd, and by the end of business that day, we had another email back that said, we're not doing the program this year. And so, my spirit jumped for joy, and I said, praise God. We're just going to step up and do it ourselves. But not by might, nor by strength, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? And that's how we're going to do that. Praise the Lord. Let's welcome Pastor Fonda as she comes to bring the partial this morning.
Amen.
Gospel, Luke 3:1-18. Isaac prays for Rebecca, not for the weak. The prayers of the righteous. The Talmud says, why were our ancestors barren? Because the Holy One, blessed be He, longs to hear the prayer of the righteous. The commentary. Isaac prayed to the Lord on behalf of his wife because she was barren, and the Lord answered him, and Rebecca, his wife, conceived. Genesis 25:21. Just as Abraham's wife Sarah was barren, Isaac's wife Rebecca was also unable to bear children. For 20 years, she and Isaac tried to have a child. It is normal for a couple to desire children, but for Isaac, it was critical. He was the inheritor of the great promises given to his father Abraham. If he did not have children, those promises could not be passed on to the next generation. Isaac turned to the Lord and entreated him on behalf of Rebecca. Rashi makes two notes on the Hebrew wording of Genesis 25:21. When it says that Isaac prayed, it uses a word that implies entreaty. Rashi explains that this means Isaac persistently prayed on her behalf. We can assume that Isaac had been praying throughout the 20 years of her barrenness. That's persistent prayer. Yeshua teaches us to pray persistently. He said persistent prayer can be compared to a witness to hear her case. Though the judge neither feared God nor respected men, he decided to hear her case lest she wear him out with her nagging. The persistent entreaty worked on such an unjust judge who neither fears God nor men, how much more so will the just judge of the universe be moved to answer our entreaties? Yeshua told another parable about the power of persistent prayer. He compared it to a man who needed to borrow food from his neighbor to feed an unexpected guest, but his neighbor had already gone to bed. The man continued to entreat his neighbor until the man eventually got out of bed and gave him what he needed. If persistent entreaty works on a lazy, reluctant neighbor, how much more so on God who neither slumbers nor sleeps? Luke 11:5-8. Yeshua encouraged us to pray persistently, saying, ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. Luke 11:9. Rashi makes a second observation on the Hebrew wording of Genesis 25:21. He notes that the Hebrew says that Isaac entreated the Lord opposite his wife. Rashi explains that Isaac stood in one corner and prayed, while Rebecca stood in the opposite corner and prayed. In other words, Isaac and Rebecca prayed together. The Lord heard the prayers of Isaac and Rebecca and answered by allowing Rebecca to conceive. Just as Sarah's conception of Isaac was a direct, miraculous intervention of God, so too with Rebecca. The Lord heard the prayers of Isaac and Rebecca and answered by allowing Rebecca to conceive. Just as Sarah's conception of Isaac was a direct, miraculous intervention of God, so too with Rebecca. There is great power in the entreaties of a husband and a wife who commit to praying together. Character and deeds. Apologies. We have not touched you and have done to you nothing but good and have sent you away in peace. Genesis 26:29. The Philistines asked Isaac for a covenant of peace on the basis that they had done nothing but good to him and that they had sent him away in peace. Isaac must have had to bite his tongue. Nothing but good sent me away in peace. Weren't these the same Philistines who had driven him from out their territory? Weren't they the same Philistines who had pursued him into the Negev and took away his wells? How could they say they had done nothing but good? Actually, this was how the Philistine apologized for the evil they had done to him and for sending him away in strife. Some people cannot apologize properly. Their ego prevents them from ever admitting any wrong on their own part. Deep inside, such a person knows that he is at fault and that he needs to make some sort of conciliatory effort. But an apology is not even a remote possibility. His pride forbids him. For example, suppose your sister is upset and says some caustic things to you. A few days later, you see her again. Unexpectedly, she is still angry. Instead, she converses with you as if her outburst a few days ago had never happened. You are bewildered. She was unkind just a few days ago, but now she's speaking to you as if the entire incident has been completely forgotten. This is her way of apologizing. Isaac was willing to overlook the foolish pride of the Philistines in order to make peace with them. So too, we should accept even half-hearted attempts at reconciliation. We should not demand a formal apology. Instead, we should be willing to take whatever modicum of peace our adversary offers.
Amen.
That was strange to me that our parts are repeated, but maybe someone needs to hear it again. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. And he put people divinely in our path. Amen.
Yes.
And he's very strategic. He's very strategic in what he's doing. Can I give an amen?
Amen.
And the reason, I guess I'll tell you publicly, that it's not a slight on Minister Deb who's been working with our youth, but the reason that we're putting Will in charge of this particular project is because it's specifically designed. I'm a behind the scenes person because it's designed to reach the African American community, and they want an African American front person. And so that's the reason. What's that? You don't qualify for that. because they want to reach. That's what I said. I said, what is my role as a white man? How do I fit into this formula? Because they want to reach the black community. And he said, Pastor, your role is to teach the truth and to tell how God loves all of us equally. And to show that demonstration, walk out in your everyday life and be behind programs like this to reach the youth in the areas that you minister. So we all have a part, we all have a role. But I wanted to say that publicly so Deb would know and you would know it's not a slide on her work. It's just the way God has appointed things, amen, for this season and why he brought Will. Now you see why God brought Will back into under our fellowship and under the IMA, yes, and we were ordained to work with us because God knew that he was bringing this program right here to us. So God's got a plan. When people can't figure it out, God knows it. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, let's I feel like we've done a lot of announcements. I'm sorry for our guests that are brand new. Scott Green, daughter of the church, and we have half the church services announced. but it's just a special time. Pray for me. I'm going to be leaving today. We're running up to minister at the resort. I'm running up to the resort that Levi lives at. It's a Slavic recovery home for men, and it's up in Washington State. And I've been asked to come and minister for 3 days. So I'll be going up there to teach and minister a little bit more. Get to see Levi and Barbara's grandson. Many of you know Levi. He's up there. He's a graduate in January. So I'll be going up there. I won't be back for Wednesday Bible study. And so it'll be in the hands of Pastor Johnny. So pray for my safe travels. Amen? I've asked the young men to go with me. Pray that God will anoint them and give them opportunities, because you know what? Young people can reach other young people better than older people can reach them. You know, and that's each of our role. Amen?
Amen.
Well, let's go. I would like our, before we have offering, I would like our worship team to just lead us in one or two more songs. And we want to have a prayer for the people. Right along. Amen. 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 Let's stand together and worship the Lord some more. This is a worship service. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You're an awesome God, Lord. You're a mighty God, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thank you.
presence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, the songs are powerful. That was the first song I ever learned to play by ear on the piano.
Hallelujah.
Touched me. And that song, it is well. I was going to admonish you that the man that wrote that had lost his wife and all of his daughters at sea. He lost his daughter, not his wife.
Lord
Jesus. Anyway, he had a telegram from one of the, either from his wife or from one of their servants that was on the ship with him that said, save the loan. The ship went down. And he got a telegram that said, save the loan. And so he was going over to England to bury his children from the United States. And he was on the very spot when the ship went down and his children died. And God gave him that song, It Is Well With My Soul. You see, the peace of God can give you that. You know, that's in the most tragic situation. And only God. Only God. We're going to be the only answer. Only God can give you that peace.
Amen.
That's what Sister Barbara, as she comes.
I'm so excited. Not just for the Miracle Sunday, but I just, I've been praying. God is giving me knowledge, wisdom, direction, I don't know what you want to call it, into helping people.
Yes.
And I have places that the Lord is showing me, and I haven't even shared this with Sister Mary yet, but God is changing. I mean, I'm changed in a changing world, and I mean, that is a miracle. You know, God is going to change her. We can't do any of it. You know what? I'm not here for offering. But I am excited about the offering, but I'm also excited because God is going to finish just what He started. And He's going to allow us, you know, by giving us the authority through the Lord to help these families, He's going to bless us. You know, churches can get too big. They can get too focused on just themselves. And instead of worshiping and instead of coming and reaching the homeless and the lost, the Lord is coming soon.
When I got the message that the baseline is all going to do it, I felt that the nurse said, you are not growing up. That was a crutch. Well, we need help. But God's saying, my people are not growing up, and I'm going to allow you to take care of this
need. Amen. You know, when we first started coming here, I felt lost because, but you know what? I have seen all of us, pointing to myself, mature in the Lord.
Praise God.
We are not babes. The Lord is giving us, you know, He gives you more as you're able to do it. I don't know the scripture, but it's as you mature, the Lord gives you more. When you're responsible, He gives you something if you're responsible for it. In Malachi 3, 10. Bring all the tithes into the storehouse that there may be food in my house. And try me now in this, which we have been doing, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessings that there will not be room enough to receive it.
Hallelujah.
Is that not what we're already doing? And all of this month when we're going to feed the homeless and the families at Thanksgiving, God is helping us.
Hallelujah.
And He's freeing us from this tax bill that we can just expand with what we're doing. Reaching families. Families. Look, it's raining outside. Look at our attendance. Better than what it can be even when the sun's shining. God is working in this church. We are not in a small church anymore. We're growing forward.
Yeah.
I don't need to tell you to give because Many of you have already come to me sharing how you're stretching and you're giving more and you're seeing what God can do for you. So with that, I say it's offering time. Let's stand. And let's just give him the praise. Remember, we still have bills, but you know that. God is using you mightily, and I praise for, I am so proud of every one of you for allowing the Lord to use you. Because many big churches don't allow the Lord to use them. Father, we just thank you right now for what you're about to do in each one of us. And in our church, oh Father, we thank you for the roof over our heads. We thank you for that you're allowing us to be used mightily. And we thank you, Lord, for what you're about to do in each one of our lives. Thank you for the bills met. Thank you for the lives. Thank you for the safety that you've given us. Father, we just thank you right now for what you're about to do. In Jesus' name, amen. And if you'll come forward, that would be wonderful.
The broken heart I have. I have difficulty, and I'm a burden in the fire department, was given 6 days to live. And when they operated on me, it left me with double vision, and they can't correct my vision. So sometimes when I'm looking at something, I can't find my choice. That's the reason I don't very often read in public. But the song has such a message. You know, if you don't mind, I'd like to sing that song, first verse over. Yes, because it has such a message. You can't really help it. I was burned in the fire department, and I was driving a fire engine for 5 weeks. And I had a staph infection in the brain that gave me 6 days to live when they found it. Then when they operated on me, I was in a 6-hour surgery. And I couldn't see to drive, I couldn't see to do anything for 10 months. My wife took over the steering wheel, and from then on I allowed her to do driving mostly. But I'll sing that first verse over with you once more.
Take Me In. He sings on the banquet with accompaniment. We bought a program that strips out the vocals, and we couldn't find the sound card. And Kevin did that for us. Thank you, Kevin. But he's never even practiced it with the sound card, so give him a little bit of praise. Amen. But I'm sure he'll be just fine. I'm proud of Caleb, and he's really, I'm proud that he's really, I'm proud because he's striving to go in the right direction.
Amen.
And he's going to use his talents for the Lord. So he asked me, usually I have to ask the young people if they'll do something. And he said, you want me to sing in church today? You know, do we sing in church today? And I said, yeah. So give me a little bit of a good luck.
Take me in to the holy of holies.
first time and to boast another time, the one and only, the elder Johnny Watts, the assistant pastor of Victory Tabernacle, and it comes to bring the word of life. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My God of grace, Lord Jesus, we thank you right now for your blessings, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your anointing, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, our hope is that decrease, Lord Jesus, you increase, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, our hope, Lord Jesus, give me the words to give to your people today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, our hope, Lord Jesus, we thank you right now, Lord Jesus, and we praise your holy name, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. First, my soul, giving honor to the Spirit of God who's ahead of my life, and to my pastor, and to all the pastors and ministers, and to the lay members in the church. We are thanking and praising the Lord for being saved, sanctified, filled with His precious Holy Ghost, that with a mighty burning fire, have a mind and a desire to serve the Lord as never before. As the saints continue to pray for each other as we continue to grow stronger and stronger in the Lord. Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah. All right.
And as they departed from Jericho, and great multitude followed him.
Mm-hmm.
And they came to Jericho, and as he went out of Jericho with his disciples and great number of the people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the high side begging.
Uh-huh.
And it came to pass that he was come nigh unto Jericho, and certain blind men sat by the wall side begging.
All right, master.
And behold, two blind men sitting by the wayside, when they heard that Jesus passed by, cried out, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, thou Son of David."
Yes.
Praise and God. The multitude rebuked them, because they should hold their peace. But they cried the more, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, thy Son of David."
Yes, Lord Jesus.
And Jesus stood still and called them and said, "What will ye that I shall do unto you?" They said unto him, "Lord, that our eyes may be opened."
Yes, praise God.
So Jesus had compassion on them, and touched their eyes, and immediately their eyes received sight, and they followed him.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes. Multitude following Christ Jesus. And we know that we are God's chosen children, so that means that we got to work for the multitude that can be able to come into Christ's house and praise Him and glorify Him. Because He's worthy to be praised, worthy to be glorified, worthy to be lifted up. And so we got to go not just in the sanctuary, we got to go out on the highways and byways and tell the people about God. And if we don't do that, we held accountable. Don't want to be held accountable for the work that God has given us, and we don't do it. So that means that we got to fast and pray. Prayer is one of the main things. And if we don't pray, we're going to miss out somewhere. Faith is another thing. We got to have faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. So when we do this, we got to do it through the grace and mercy of God. So when these blind men began sitting on the wayside, and you take right now, there's a lot of people that is blind, not naturally so, but spiritually so.
Yes.
And that's our job, to help them to get in and make a way, an opportunity to see God when He comes back.
Yes.
Blind is one of the things that you find a lot of people is naturally blind. And these two were. And they cried along that highway and the byway, "Lord, help me have mercy on me." And when you have mercy on somebody, you're doing the work of God. And by them crying out, the multitude thought they were supposed to be silent and say nothing, just let him pass by. But they wanted to be healed from their blindness that they might see. And when they done this, the Lord came to a standstill and called them out. Laid his hands upon their eyes and they will be able to see. And it's a possibility that they've been blind all their life. And you take a lot of people that have been blind all their life and hadn't ever seen anything with this new system that they have. They can do this eye exam, this eye work that they do with this laser type thing, and cause people to be able to see. But God has his way of teaching you how to see. And what you need to see. And one of the main things that we need to see and understand is God's word. And we need to study his word daily, not part of the time, not half of the time, but daily, to understand his word. The more we study, the closer we get to him, and the closer he'll come to us. But if we neglect studying his word and understanding his word, and says, why ain't the Lord doing the thing that I might have asked him to do? Simply because you are not doing the work God called you to do. And we have people walking up and down the street. And we had some people right across the street here, sleeping in a big field back there. And they wiped out everything that they were using. But they figured out another way. And they brought another mattress and put it in the same place they had before to get rest. But God always has a way of doing things.
Yes, he does.
And we have to believe him and we have to trust him.
Yes,
and we know what the Lord can do and what the Lord will do if we depend on him and if we trust him and have that faith in him. And when we have that faith and that trust in God, what we ask, he shall provide.
Yes, amen.
He says, ask and it shall be given, seek and ye shall find, knock and the door shall be open. And if we don't step forward and do what the Lord wants us to do, then we're going to miss out along the way. Praise God. And we are the ones that got to gather the multitude. And thinking about what the pastor just said, God is setting up a way to gather the multitude, to bring into his sanctuary, to be able to praise and glorify God. Because God's got more than one way of doing things. We think it should be done our way and only our way. But God says, do it my way or don't do it at all.
Yes, amen.
Because when we do it God's way, we know it's going to be done right.
Amen.
We know it's going to be done right.
Yes, it is.
But if we try to do it our way, there will be mistakes made. But when God do it, it's done right, it's done on time. And say, you can't hurry God. You got to trust him
and get in time. He may not come when you want him to come, but he's always right on time. He's an on-time God. If God is, is an on-time God, why can't we be on time?
Amen.
Hallelujah. We open up Sunday school, open up early. Why can't it usually about a half a dozen in Sunday school? Some that will come in, that's slack off. But God has a way of getting you back into his sanctuary. Sunday school is the beginning of learning about God.
Amen.
A lot of people don't understand that. Sunday school is the beginning. And when you start in Sunday school learning about God's word, then you can step forward. And when you step forward far enough in God, and he has a job for you to do, you will be able to do that job without any problems. Because God can make that way straight and narrow. And when he makes it straight, there will be no mistakes. And we got to make sure that we do what God wants us to do and not what we want to do. Because we are part of the multitude that God is calling upon. And that means we got to go up and down the streets and in the neighborhoods and talk to the people and let them know, hey, there's a church right close to you. There's a sanctuary right close to you. So come on over. Make sure you get to Sunday school. Sunday school starts at 9. Regular service starts at 10:30. And if we don't let them know, they'll never know. And when they do decide to come, service is dead and service is gone. But we got to make sure that we do what God wants us to do and not what we want to do. And we can't say, well, I can do as I please. No. No, you can't. Not in God's house, you can't. If you believe in God and trust in God, you can and you won't. Because you know he's in charge. God is in charge of everything. In charge of your job, your home, your clothes, your food, and everything. God is in charge of it. And when God is in charge, you got to know that he is the master of all things. He's the King of kings, Lord of lords, Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end, the first and the last. And so we got to trust him. We got to believe in him. Because if we don't believe in him and trust in him, we are the living, walking church. Every day, somebody sees you. Sees the way you carry yourself, sees your attitude. And they're going to think, well, I thought that he was a minister for God. I thought she was a missionary. I thought she was the mother of the church. I thought she or he was the director of the choir or usher. But we got to remember to lean and depend on God. Lean and depend on him. Because mama and daddy ain't going to be there. Sister and brother ain't going to be there. But God is always there. You can call him early in the morning. You can call him in the middle of the day. Late in the evening, in the midnight hour. His line is never busy. But the rest of the lines might be. But God's line is never busy. says, I got a telephone in my bosom. I can call him up and tell him what I want. If you want your body healed, call him up. If you want your soul saved, call him up. If you need the Holy Ghost, call him up. God is a God that he'll answer prayer. He may not answer when you want it, but it'll always be right on time. Because he's an on-time God. That's the reason why we are the disciples. We are God's disciples. So we got to do the work God called us to do. We can't half do it, and we can't play like we're doing it. We got to do it and do it from the heart. With love and kindness. Since love and kindness have not wronged me. And that means we have to do it for the people that are out on the street. With love and kindness. I got maybe two or three. Stop, sit, and talk. Regardless to how hot it is or how cool it is, if they see me sitting outside, they're going to stop. And that lets you know that somebody somewhere has God in their life. And other people are looking and searching about God and want to know what God can do and what God will do. If you have problems, ask God and he'll take them away. But you got to be sincere about it. You can't say, well, Lord, if you do this and if you do that, I'll leave this alone and I'll leave that alone. No. You got to be sincere about it. You got to ask the Lord, say, Lord, if it's alcohol, take the taste. Take it.
Amen.
Tobacco, take it.
Amen.
Drugs, take it.
Amen.
And when God takes these things away from you, you can't stand the odor. Hi! The odor of it. The odor of it will make you sick just a smell.
Yes, it will.
That's the reason why we have to depend on God. We have to trust him. And when we turn it all over to the Lord, he'll work it out. I can't work it out for you. You can't work it out for yourself. But God can. He can do it a lot quicker and a lot faster than you think he can. Because he can do it in a twinkling and a snapping of an eye. And you wonder why. Because God is an on-time God. He's a just God. We can't hurry. We just have to wait on him. And a lot of people holler about, well, how come it wasn't done today? I was expecting it today. But what you expect today may not come until tomorrow when God says it's so. And when we put our trust in him and believe in him, everything will work out the way God wants it to work out. Not the way we want it to work out, but the way he wants it to work out. Hallelujah to Jesus. Glory to God. That's the reason why we're working as hard as we can to get the multitude into God's house. To give him the praise, the honor, and the glory. Because he's the only one can work things out.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah to Jesus. Wait and watch you. Wait and watch you. Wait in the water.
Oh, water.
God's gonna trouble the water. In the water to wait,
in the water did run away. In the water, God, the water, take God's glory from all the water. See that whole star dressed in red. God's glory from all the water. See that whole star dressed in red. God's going to trouble the water. See we in the water, children, away. In the water, children, away. In the water, God's going to trouble the water. See, God's going to trouble the water. You don't believe I'm serious. God's going to trouble the water. Follow me down to the Jersey stream. God's going to trouble the water. Till we in the water, children, wait. In the water, children, wait. In the water, God's going to trouble the water. See, God's going to trouble the water. Woo-wee. In the water, children, wait. In the water, children, wait. In the water, God's going to trouble the water. See, God's going to trouble the water. Wait. In the water, children, wait. In the water, children, wait. In the water, God's going to trouble the water.
Hallelujah to Jesus.